co-founder of the Goss Michael Foundation, and George Michael's former partner, Kenny Goss.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be here. I wish George was here with us. He's such a wonderful man. It's great to be back surrounded by the love of Project Angel Food. When George volunteered here in 1980, I was here with him. It was 1998. We made white cakes. And I've got to tell you, he was so impressed with the staff and the volunteers, the quality of the food, and the compassion embedded in the meals. He and I started the Goss Michael Foundation in 2007, and we raised millions of dollars for worthy charities and causes. And you all know, and I've always known, his entire life he secretly donated to many people and charities, including Project Angel Food. I'm so happy that George is finally getting the recognition he deserves with Project Angel Food's Elizabeth Taylor Leadership Award. There's been a lot said about George since he died, but I'd love for his legacy to be his music and his generosity. I often talk to George, and I'd like to say I love you, darling, and I hope you're proud. Thank you.
Is the most important word in the world right now. Let me see you. See your hands. Hear your voices.
Okay, we've got some breaking news coming to us here.
Reports that George Michael, the singer and songwriter, has died. He was
British
just
pop star George Michael has passed away at the age.
A supernova in a firmament of shining stars had been extinguished, and it felt like the sky had fallen in.
I felt numb at first. I remember the last time we spoke, which wasn't that long ago. Even after we split up, we remained great friends. He is absolutely one of the kindest, generous men I've ever met. He always said to me, how much money does someone really need in their bank account? He firmly believed that we need to help people as much as we can. I met George here in Los Angeles. I was here working with a sporting goods company, and he asked me out. George and I came into the kitchen. We made cakes, white cakes that day. I was a lot better at making the cakes than him.
Workers say that they couldn't get through the door. There were paparazzi at the front door, paparazzi at the back door, helicopters.
So I just kind of helped facilitate. I helped find ingredients for him, and he measured them, and he enjoyed the fact that the mixing bowl that we had was so big. And I was just overwhelmed by the generosity in his speech and the benevolence that he had towards our agency.
I would say several years ago is when I first found out about Project Angel Food. It was with Kenny and George. I knew that they both would come in and donate, and I knew how much that meant to George, and he loved it. Well, it just is so close to our hearts. That's why I'm here. And call your girlfriends and have them come and help you. Whenever we're working in the kitchen, one of George's songs comes on, Freedom, which was one of his most popular ones with all the supermodels.
Made us dance and work faster.
Everybody has always thought of me as a harpist. The record with Bjork comes out. George went to Tower Records in London and he bought that album. And he said, find this woman, I've got to record with her.
This is what I did with George.
They said, what kind of music should we prepare for you? And I said, none. Just put me in the studio with George, with just the two of us. I mean, just, you know, it's I Remember You, because George loved that song.
I remember you.
Well, I didn't mean George's legacy, of course, as we know now, is that he was the most generous, kind person.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Elton John! Elton John, I recently heard a comment he made, and he said, George was a humanitarian from the top of his head to the tip of his toe. And he really felt that way.
In 1993, Project Angel Food was getting an influx of people living with AIDS, and we weren't sure how we were going to make payroll. Then all of a sudden, out of the blue, an envelope appeared at our doorstep, and a handwritten note said, "Project Angel Food, keep doing what you're doing. Love, George." And out came a check for $25,000. That check kept coming every year until the day he died.
I think now people will remember him. I think the things he did in his life for other people will be remembered just as much as his music.
When I was raising money for the Terence Higgins Trust, George gave $50,000, and he did it anonymously.
I knew he was generous, but he never talked about it. He never said, "Yes, I sent some money to this woman who was ill," or anything. He never said anything.
And it wasn't until he died that people started finding out.
George just didn't stop giving. It was for people, it was for animals, it was for children, it was for women. He never, ever, ever stopped.
George Michael is the single largest individual donor in the history of Project Angel Food, donating nearly $500,000.
You know her from Grey's Anatomy, Shameless, and NYPD Blue. Currently on Oprah Winfrey Network's praise drama series, Queen Sugar, Miss Sharon Lawrence.
Hi, everybody. Wasn't that beautiful to see a man who we all love and miss? And I have the distinct pleasure of not only being with you tonight and sharing this family atmosphere, but actually reading a message from George Michael's sisters. They sent a letter, and I'm going to read it from my phone just because it's easier. And I want you to know that they asked for us to wait to read this letter until this precise moment. So you'll be hearing it first here. "Hello to all at Project Angel Food, all the guests, visitors, and the participants gathered in this celebration in Los Angeles this evening, from Yioda and Melanie. We send our best regards from London and hope that everything is going well." I think we can answer that as a yes, right? Right? "We are glad and pleased that you are honoring George this evening for his contribution alongside the many, many dedicated volunteers throughout the years to Project Angel Food. And we hope that the joy of hearing the beautiful words and the music from Adam will remind you of George's gift of music and help him live in your lives. Knowing his music and support have helped many of you when you've needed your spirits lifted, your sadness reflected, or just a great dance round the kitchen, was a source of great pride for him. And if he's looking down on you today, we're sure that he would rightly feel that together you did a good thing. Throughout his life, George's sense of justice and fairness and caring always came to the fore in many kind deeds. So Project Angel Food being one of many. So we are justly proud of his quiet examples of caring and generosity. We all need some love sometimes, but we always need dinner at dinner time. So thank you. Enjoy your evening. And at the request of George's family, we will now invite a client to the stage to accept the award in their honor. So Greg Shore, would you please come forward? Maybe you're backstage. Oh, there you are, Greg. We met out earlier in the reception. He came and spoke so well of the organization and being a client. And so he's on his way up. Okay.
Hi, I'm Greg, and I'm a client of Project Angel Food, and I'm here to represent all the clients, and thank you all. I received my first meal in January 2016, and it's no cliche to say that I owe my life to Project Angel Food and all of you. Thank you. The gentleman from KTLA had mentioned something, and I want to reinforce it, that Project Angel Food is not just food, it's people. And because of that, I invited my delivery driver, Keith, who's way back there, Keith, who's become a great friend. And I also want to give a shout out to Terry, who runs the front desk, who's helped me so many times. There haven't been many perks to this last 2.5 years, but finding Project Angel Food and all of you people has certainly been one. So I want to thank you all. Thank you. On behalf of the great George Michael, I'd like to accept this award. And on behalf of all the clients, thank you very much. Wow.
Well done.
Now, one more thing before I set us up for one of the highlights of the evening. Because this is a family atmosphere, we take care of each other, right? So, someone dropped a driver's license by our table, and I'm going to make sure he gets it back. All right, Devin Michael Jones. Oh, you're right there. And you were born on September the 27th. You got a birthday coming up, honey. Here you go. I didn't mention the year. Just that. Actually, I owe that to, yeah, that table 28. We stick together, don't we? We look out for our own. Yeah, right on. All right. One of the great takeaways for me tonight is the selfie that I actually got to take with this next powerhouse. And you all will get a chance to not only photograph him, but hear him up close and personal. He is very generous with his talents. As a matter of fact, he took the night off from a tour that he's doing of the music of Queen. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, a great star, Adam Lambert. I see him. There he is. Oh, his band's coming on. Wow, look at all of them. Oh, fantastic. This is so hot. I'm not even going to leave until they get set up here because this is just really... Somebody take my picture so I can actually believe that this happened. Woo! Hi, guys. All right. Now, without further ado... Adam Lambert.
It would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you, but I gotta think twice before I give my heart away. And I know all the games you play because I play them too. Ooh, but I need some time off from that emotion. Time to pick my heart up off the floor. I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Because I gotta have faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. Baby, I know you're asking me to stay. Say please, please, please don't go away. You say I'm giving you the blues. Maybe you mean every word you say. Can't help but think of yesterday when another one attacked.
I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Cause I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith.
Thank you. Let me bring these monitors up a touch. You guys having fun? Yeah? Who won things? I thought there was a lot of like auctioning going on down here. Yeah, everybody's happy, no buyer's remorse. Everything good? Good. All right, I'm going to try to get kind of serious now, even though I'm feeling like I want to, yeah. Okay, let's sing a song. I know it's wrong, just let me go. Thank you so much. Oh, that song just, I mean, George Michael was like God-gifted voice from the heavens. It's such a treat to sing for you guys tonight and to bring these songs to life right now. George was amazing. He raised $500,000 for this organization since 1989. And he is such an inspiration, both as a philanthropist and as an artist. Now, something that some people don't know is that he actually did a cover of a Queen song. Now, I know my way around a couple of Queen songs. And actually, round circle here is that he recorded this song for the Freddie Mercury tribute in 1991 after Freddie had passed. And the song became a huge hit. So I'm gonna connect the circle and we're gonna do Somebody to Love.
Hey! Each morning I get up, I die a little, can barely stand on my feet. Take a look in the mirror and cry, Lord, what you doing to me? I spent all my years in believing you, but I just somebody can anybody find me? Somebody love, yeah. I work hard every day of my life. I work till I
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for sharing this evening with us. If you're a silent auction winner, please claim your prize and visit the checkout in the cocktail area. We hope to see you again next year. Now drive safely. Thank you again.